1986 Sweetwater Mustangs had a tough act to follow in the 1985 state championship squad. But each week during the season, they proved over and over again that they were underrated by sports writers locally and out of town. Big Red 1986 had what it took. In preseason scrimmages, the 1986 Mustangs showed promise, handily beating 5A Cooper and 4A Brownwood. Coming off those impressive showings, the Mustangs faced Merkle in the season opener, and it would seem that Sweetwater took the Badgers too lightly. It should have been a blowout against 3A Merkle, but a sputtering Mustang offense, mistakes, and penalties kept the Big Red squad from scoring most of the evening. Merkle and Sweetwater did little in the first quarter of play, and it wasn't until the second period that the Mustangs got untracked and put points on the board. Quarterback Chris Davis connected with number 83, Kenneth Norman, for a 51-yard touchdown pass. Lee Morris kicked the extra point. The Mustang defense began showing its toughness by shutting down the Merkle offense. And the Sweetwater offense got the ball again, thanks to this fumble recovery by number 82, Roan Reed. Tailback Rufus Smith then took a pitch out from Chris Davis, and he raced 14 yards for the touchdown. Lee Morris's kick made it 14-zip. The third quarter was scoreless for both teams. But in the fourth, Chris Davis hit Kenneth Norman with another pass for the final touchdown. The Mustangs had beaten Merkle 20-0, limiting the Badgers to only 50 yards total offense and only 3 first downs for the entire game. Abilene High dealt the 1985 state championship Mustang team its only defeat. And the 1986 Big Red squad was ready for revenge at home. They jumped on the Eagles early. Mark Redden had a good night, as you can see in this opening play. Rufus Smith dodged around the Eagle defense for long gains on the ground, too. The Mustang offense chalked up 13 points in the first quarter. One touchdown came on a 9-yard run by quarterback Chris Davis. Lee Morris kicked the extra point to make it 7-0 Sweetwater. The Mustang defense hung tough. They dominated the Abilene Eagles. The offense took over once again. This time, number 43, Mark Redden, took it up the middle for 25 yards. Four plays and a motion penalty later, the Mustangs' second TD came on a pass from Davis to tight end Lee Morris for 7 yards. The extra point try was no good. If the first quarter was good for Sweetwater, the second was even better. Mark Redden dashed 23 yards for another touchdown. Thank you. extra point. Sweetwater's answer to Doomsday, the defense, kept the pressure up on the Abilene Eagles. And on the next offensive possession, Kenneth Norman scored on a 64-yard pass play from Chris Davis. The extra point attempt failed, and the Mustangs led Abilene 26-0. On the next defensive series, Kenneth Norman snagged an Eagle pass, and the offense was back in business. And the offense knew what to do with it. Rone Reed took a pass from Chris Davis and ran it in for another Sweetwater touchdown. Lee Morris's extra point kick made it Sweetwater 33, Abilene 0 at halftime. In the third quarter, the Mustangs were not so successful offensively. But the Abilene offense got a big boost from Junior Bell, who came into the game, took the Mustang kickoff, and then scooted 90 yards for a touchdown. Porterway's kick made the score 33-7, Sweetwater. The Mustangs took the kickoff. Redden took it from Heeler on the Texas Star play, and he ran it to midfield. But the offense couldn't score for the remainder of the third quarter. But the Abilene offense couldn't get anything started either, and the third quarter ended with a score remaining, Sweetwater 33, Abilene 7. In the fourth quarter, another Eagle drive was stalled with this interception by number 83, Kenneth Norman. Six plays later, Davis connected with a pass to Lee Morris at the 6-yard line. Rufus Smith punched it in for the score several plays later. Morris's kick made the score 40-7. Later in the fourth, Junior Bell went across the goal line again for the Eagles. And the game ended with sweet revenge for Sweetwater, 40-14, the final score. The Mustangs open district play against Big Spring. Cellar Dwellers is a 5A team. Big Spring had dropped down to 4A for the first time in many seasons. The game turned out to be the low point of the 1986 season for the Mustangs. Steers scored on their opening drive and soon led the Mustangs 7-0. The Mustangs took the kickoff. Mark Redden returned the ball back to their own 47-yard line. Because of mistakes and penalties, however, Redden's run was for nothing. The drive stopped just short of the goal line, and Sweetwater remained scoreless in the first quarter. In the middle of the second quarter, both Sweetwater and Big Spring had sputtered on the first couple of possessions. The Mustangs began their first scoring drive of the evening. Smith put Sweetwater on the board by taking a last-minute pitch out from Chris Davis and running it 20 yards for the touchdown. Lee Morris kicked the extra point to tie the game. The Mustang defense put the pressure on Big Spring and kept the Steers from scoring again in the second quarter. quarter, Lee Morris kicked a 39-yard field goal for the go-ahead score. In the third quarter, the Mustang defense went to work and held the Steers scoreless. The offense did the job. Rufus Smith chewed up the yards on carries. Chris Davis kept it when he had to and took the ball upfield. Later, the offense chalked up more points with a 4-yard touchdown run by Rufus Smith and the extra point kick by Lee Morris. In the fourth, the bottom fell out. Down by 10 points, Big Spring first scored a touchdown on a 60-yard punt return. Two-point conversion try was successful. The Mustangs tried to keep the lead, but they couldn't gain any more ground. Later, a 24-yard pass play led to another Big Spring touchdown. The 22-17 loss was a major one for the Mustangs, but most later felt the game strengthened Sweetwater's determination to finish up a winner. Back home the next week in Mustang Bowl, La Mesa was the second district opponent. And again, the defense worked hard, but offensive errors kept Sweetwater from making the game a blowout. Mark Redden tallied the first points for Sweetwater, charging 31 yards for this touchdown. Thanks to Lee Morris's kick, the Mustangs led La Mesa 7-0 as the second quarter got underway. With plays like this one by Kyle Dobie, the Big Red defense almost totally dominated the Golden Tornadoes. In the second quarter, the Mustang offense picked up. Chris Davis moved the ball. Rufus Smith then rushed 5 yards for this second quarter Mustang TD. Morris kicked the extra point, and the Mustangs led 14-0 at the half. La Mesa still couldn't score the points in the third quarter thanks to the tough defensive play by the Mustangs, in this case, Matt McMillan and Brad Baldwin. Harry Marcus got in his licks, too. The Mustang offense scored another touchdown in the third, this one on a 12-yard pass from Chris Davis to Lee Morris. In the fourth quarter, this interception ended a Mustang offensive drive. And it set up the only score of the night for the Golden Tornadoes. But Big Red pushed the ball back down the other end of the field and scored again, this time on a 1-yard rush by Rufus Smith. The final score, Sweetwater 28, La Mesa 7. Fort Stockton was next on the Sweetwater list, but the big winner in this contest was torrential rain that kept things soaking and sloppy all night long in Panther Stadium. There were plenty of mistakes on both sides. Durrell Rather fell in a Panther fumble in the first quarter. It led to this Chris Davis touchdown from 4 yards out for the first Sweetwater score. Defensively, the Mustangs were active in spite of the soggy field. In the second quarter, safety Larry Heeler intercepted this Fort Stockton pass to halt a scoring drive. Matt McMillan recovered a Panther fumble, and later on, Billy Wooten did the same. Sweetwater's other scores came on a 19-yard pass from Chris Davis to Kenneth Norman, and this 8-yard run by Rufus Smith. The final score was Sweetwater 18, Fort Stockton nothing. The next week at home, Pecos was visiting, and the game turned out to be a tough one. The scoring went this way. Rufus Smith took the handoff from Chris Davis in the first quarter, and he dashed 4 yards for the first score. Israel Vera kicked the extra point. Pecos' slippery quarterback, Bobby Smith, accounted for the only Eagle score of the first quarter with this 75-yard pass play to Javier Estrella. Tony Urquidy's kick tied it up. Neither team could score in the second quarter of play. But in the third, the Mustang offense again broke loose. Lee Morris snagged a 10-yard pass from Chris Davis for the score, and then he kicked the extra point. The Mustang defense toughened up on Pecos. Kenneth Norman chalked up 4 interceptions in the game. That's one short of tying the district record. In the fourth quarter, quarterback Chris Davis accounted for the final Mustang score with a 3-yard run. The Mustangs had beaten Pecos 21-7. The big game of the year has almost always been against Monahans, and this year was the same without doubt. In fact, it was one of the top games in memory for many Mustang fans. Sweetwater played near-perfect football during this crucial district contest. The Lobos, however, scored first, and briefly at least, things looked a little bleak for Sweetwater. Monahan's top-rated tailback, Charles Thompson, weaved his way 71 yards through the Mustang defense for the score. With the score now 7-0, Sweetwater began its comeback. On Monahan's second possession, Thompson fumbled the ball, and Darrell Rather fell on it for the Mustang. Quarterback Chris Davis capped off a 6-play drive by passing for a 27-yard play to Kenneth Norman and the first Mustang touchdown. The extra point try failed, leaving the score 7-6, Monahan's. Through the rest of the first quarter, the Mustang defense proved it was tops, shutting down Monahan's blue ribbon offense. In the second quarter, Elmer Green scored for Sweetwater after catching this Chris Davis pass. Then Davis passed to Jimmy Henderson in the end zone for the 2-point conversion. The score now, Sweetwater 14, Monahan 7. Later in the second, Monahan's tied the game up on a Dana Amos touchdown run. The extra point kick was good, and the game was tied at 14 at halftime. While they were perhaps uptight when the game began, the Mustangs were loose when they returned to the field after halftime. Larry Heeler gave the Mustangs good field position to begin the second half, taking the opening kickoff back up to the 48-yard line. In the first offensive series of the third quarter, Mark Redden ran up the middle for this crucial first down. A few plays later, Rufus Smith took a pitch out from Chris Davis and came up with another big game for Sweetwater. 2 plays later, another Mustang score was added to the tally with a 6-yard Chris Davis touchdown. three-point conversion try was unsuccessful. The Big Red defense went to work and continued to dominate Monahan, refusing to give up crucial ground. In the fourth quarter, it was all Mustangs again. Linebacker Daryl Rather fell on another Lobo fumble. And the Mustang offense began a drive that almost fizzled out. But on fourth down, with only inches to go, Davis fired a pass to tight end Lee Morris. With the first down, the Mustangs drove down to the one. And Davis carried it in for the score. Davis then passed to Roan Reed for two extra points. 28-14, Sweetwater. The defense took over again, and Daryl Rather recovered still another fumble that set up another Mustang drive. But the drive stalled, and the Mustangs were forced to punt. But thanks to the defense, the Mustangs got another chance. Chris Davis hit Kenneth Norman with a pass that put six more points on the board. Time ran out with a score of Sweetwater 34, Monahan's 14. It was a huge win that built up the Mustang confidence and also made opponents to come take serious notice. Sweetwater and Snyder have had a strong rivalry for as long as most fans can remember. But again this year, the Mustangs dominated. The Tigers had the size, but the Mustangs had everything they needed to take control of this game. Snyder did tally the first score of the game with this field goal by Randy Townsend. But Big Red blasted back. Davis connected with Elmer Green for a big aerial gain. Then Rufus Smith ran 62 yards for the first Sweetwater touchdown. Morris kicked the extra point, and the score was 7-3, Sweetwater. In the second quarter, Townsend struck again for Snyder, putting this kick through the uprights from 41 yards out. But on the next Mustang drive, Kenneth Norman drew in this 24-yard pass from Chris Davis and scampered in for the score. Elmer Green turned disaster into success by running the ball across the line for two extra points. Sweetwater erupted for 14 more points in the third quarter. One of those touchdowns came from Harry Marcus on a run of 11 yards. Morris's kick made the score 22-6. The defense stayed in Snyder's back pocket all night. Tiger quarterback Brad Gartman tried one too many passes. Safety Larry Heeler intercepted this one and ran it back to the 32. That set up the second Mustang touchdown of the third quarter, which also came from Harry Marcus. But this time, Marcus flogged it 73 yards down the sidelines for the end zone. In the fourth quarter, with a score of 29-6, the second offensive unit went into the game, and no one had doubts about their capability to run the Mustang offense. With Larry Heeler as quarterback, the Mustangs began the drive. A pitch out to Norman took them to the nine. Heeler handed off to Billy Wooten, who lunged across the line for the score. Wooten repeated on the next Sweetwater possession. He took Heeler's handoff at the line of scrimmage and slashed his way 50 yards for the goal line. Mustangs had defeated the Tigers 43-6, holding Snyder to only 200 yards total offense while chalking up 474 themselves. The next week, Sweetwater dominated Andrews. The Mustangs had it under control from the opening kickoff. Mark Redden gained 27 yards on two carries. On the fifth play, Harry Marcus took the Davis pitch out and scored from 10 yards away. Israel Vera kicked the extra point to make the score Sweetwater 7, Andrews nothing. After the kickoff, the defense made a break. Safety Larry Healer picked off an Andrews pass and ran it back 25 yards. That interception led to this Chris Davis touchdown from the 10-yard line. Again, Vera's kick was good, and the score was 14-0. The Sweetwater defense held tough, and later in the first quarter, Kenneth Norman intercepted another Andrews pass and ran it back 40 yards. The touchdown that followed was called back by a penalty, and the Mustang drive ended. In the second quarter, the Mustangs began a long touchdown drive. That drive ended with a 4-yard touchdown pass to number 82, Rome Reed. With the score now 21-0, the defense cracked down harder on Andrews. Late in the second quarter, Healer snagged another Andrews pass, giving the Mustangs another offensive opportunity. But time ran out before the Mustangs could score again. On their first possession of the second half, Andrews continued to have problems getting any kind of offense going. The Mustangs had no such difficulty. Mark Redden, Harry Marcus, and Chris Davis made the gains when they were needed. Then Mark Redden took the handoff from Davis and bounced outside to the goal line. Vera's extra point made it 28-0. At the beginning of the fourth quarter, Healer got his third interception at Andrews' expense. But offensively, the fourth quarter was mostly stalemate due to player substitutions. With less than 2 minutes left in the game, however, Tony Atkins intercepted an Andrews pass and returned it 24 yards for a touchdown. The extra point try was unsuccessful, but the 34-0 win over Andrews virtually assured the Mustangs of their third straight trip to the playoffs. The regular season for the Mustangs came to a good close at home against San Angelo Lakeview. But the game was a little strange. Both offenses seemed to run wild, but the Sweetwater defense clinched the win. The first quarter was the calmest all night for the Sweetwater Mustangs. They scored only 7 points in the first period. Rufus Smith ran 6 yards for the first TD after taking a pitch out from Chris Davis. Israel Vera supplied the extra point to make it 7. Lakeview tried, but Roan Reed, Brad Balthrop, and the rest of the Mustang defense had other ideas. The Mustangs tried too, but they couldn't muster any more points in the first quarter. In the second, however, the offense broke loose. Kenneth Norman scored on a 75-yard pass play from Chris Davis. With a 13-0 lead, the Mustang front line stayed stingy. And on the next offensive possession, Smith capped the Mustang drive with a 2-yard walk over the goal line. Vera kicked the extra point to make it 20-0. The Chiefs tried to chip away at the defense, but they still couldn't put points on the board. Brad Balthrop snagged a late view pass to give possession back to Sweetwater. And soon the Mustangs were knocking at the door again. Chris Davis ran another one into the end zone from 8 yards out. And Vera kicked the extra point for a 27-0 lead over Lakeview at halftime. The second half got everyone's attention. Sweetwater and Lakeview swapped points. Lots of them. Lakeview got on the board with an almost busted 60-yard pass play. The extra point kick was good. But Sweetwater was coming back. Mark Redden broke loose on a long run. And Rufus Smith took it over the line from 14 yards out. Vera kicked another one through the uprights, and that made the score 27-7. The defense went back to work against Lakeview and shut him down again. And on the next possession, Smith took the ball in after a 25-yard run for the second Mustang TD of the third quarter. The score now, 34-7. Lakeview wasn't through. The Chiefs hit on a couple of long pass plays. And they added another score on this 5-yard run. Roughly the same thing happened in the fourth quarter. The Mustangs kept on scoring, but so did the Chiefs. Rufus Smith took another one in from 2 yards out for the Mustangs' first score of the fourth quarter. And there was another successful extra point kick by Israel Vera. Despite the big gap in the score, the Chiefs didn't just lie down belly up. With the help of some penalties in their favor, Lakeview hit on a short pass play for the third score of the night. And the point after attempt was good. The Mustangs took over on their own 43-yard line and marched steadily down the field. Harry Marquez again took the Heeler handoff and ran 3 yards for his touchdown. And Vera's kick was good to complete the Mustangs' scoring for the night. Lakeview still had one more chance, and they came back for one more touchdown pass. But the final score was Sweetwater 55, Lakeview 28. It was the most the Mustangs had scored in a game all season, but it was also the game in which they gave up the most points. The Mustangs' third straight trip into the playoffs was against Lubbock Estacado, a tough, quick team the Mustangs had beaten at home last year on their way to the state championship. The Matadors were out to avenge last year's loss, but the Mustangs had other ideas, and that made this probably the most exciting game in recent memory for fans and players alike. The Mustangs won the toss. They knew what they wanted to do, and they did it. But on the their first possession that just wasn't quite enough. The punt put Estacado in a deep hole, and the defense kept him there, recovering a fumble at the 5. Chris Davis chalked up the first points with this 4-yard run. The extra point kick by Israel Vera made it 7-0. Estacado's first possession of this bi-district game was not very productive. The drive was stopped cold by this interception by safety Larry Heeler. The combination of Chris Davis and Lee Morris launched the resulting Sweetwater possession. But the Matador defense halted that drive. In the second quarter, Estacado threatened to score again, but the defense slammed the door in their faces. The Matadors decided to try for a field goal, but Neely's kick was blocked, and Kyle Doby got it in his grip. On the resulting possession, the Mustangs drove to midfield. On fourth down, Lee Morris came in to punt. Instead, the coaches called a fake and then a quick pass. Estacado's Bernard Anderson flashed in front of the intended receiver, snagged the pass, and then dashed 58 yards for the touchdown. The extra point kick tied it up at 7-all at the half. The third quarter belonged to Estacado. The Matadors opened scoring in the third quarter with this 32-yard run. But Curtis Neely missed the extra point. That left the score 13-7, Estacado. But the Mustangs caught up quickly. Chris Davis on the keeper, running from 34 yards out for this score. Israel Vera added on the extra point, and the Mustangs retook the lead, 14-13. Estacado was still in the game, however. It looked like a busted play, but the Matadors tallied more points with this 25-yard touchdown run for the go-ahead score. But the pass for 2 extra points fell incomplete. The Mustang offense began the fourth quarter with some good gains, won by Mark Redden. Sweetwater finally pulled ahead with a 1-yard touchdown run by Mark Redden. The 2-point conversion failed, but the Mustangs had the lead, 20-19. Now all the powerful Sweetwater defense had to do was hold on. It all came down to this Estacado field goal attempt. With the seconds ticking away, Curtis Neely's kick fell way short. The Mustangs had won by district by a score of 20-19. They now advance to the regional contest against Wichita Falls Hershey. On that Saturday afternoon in Mustang Bowl against the Hershey Huskies, mistake after mistake hurt the Mustangs. The first quarter was another defensive slugfest. Neither side could score the points, although both teams came close. Powerful Mustang defense stayed on the Huskies' backs constantly. The Mustang Brain Trust tried a lot of different things against the Huskies, but they still couldn't get the points on the board in the first quarter. Quarter-long ride on the seesaw continued. Early in the second, the Huskies drew in their first interception of the long afternoon. Mustang defense again hung tough as they've done all season long. But on the next play, the Huskies put points on the board. The score came on this 40-yard pass play. The extra point was tacked on and Hershey led 7-0. Mustang offense began its work. Chris Davis on the keeper weaved his way through the Huskies before finally being tackled at the 1 foot line. But Davis went out with an ankle injury. The Mark Cotherman snap to Larry Heeler failed to connect, and Hershey recovered the loose ball. The Big Red defense went back to work. And soon they forced Hershey to punt the ball away. Backup quarterback Larry Heeler began the drive that would lead to the first Mustang score of the day. Using his backs, Heeler began leading the offense toward the goal. Chris Davis returned to the game on this series, and he soon fired a 21-yard pass to Kenneth Norman for the first Sweetwater score. Israel Vera's extra point kick was good, and both teams went into the locker room at the half tied 7-7. In the third quarter, the defense aimed to contain Hershey, and they did. But so did Hershey's defense. And soon it was a contest to see which side can make the most mistakes. Hershey went to the air, and Elmer Green leaped up for the interception. On the first Mustang offensive play, the Huskies fell on a fumble and took the ball back. Only a few plays later, safety Larry Heeler snagged a pass from in front of a Hershey receiver, and the Mustangs were back in business. Hershey killed the Mustangs with this interception. Reggie Flannoy dodged through Mustang defenders to the goal line 17 yards away. The extra point kick was good, and Hershey had won 14-7, earning the right to advance and dashing the hopes for a Mustang repeat of the state championship. The Hershey game was a tough loss, but the Mustangs, those the sports writers boosted regularly and those who were unsung, have every reason to be proud of the 1986 season. They rebounded from the Big Spring loss when any other team might have been crushed. They met their toughest opponents in the middle of the field and proceeded to beat them soundly. It was a good year, and the fans thanked the 1986 Mustangs for keeping Friday nights fun. We're all looking ahead to 1987, confident that with the talent remaining and the fine coaching staff, the Mustangs have a pretty good chance of going to the playoffs again.